Hello friends, a warm welcome. This is Advocate Dipinderjeet Kaur working as a legal associate at NRI Legal Services. Today I'm going to apprise you all regarding the property related issues of NRIs. Non-resident Indians are often the victims of the property encroachment since they are living overseas with limited ability to manage their properties in India. The land belonging to the NRIs becomes an easy target for encroachment because the wrongdoers know that the NRIs are not able to supervise their property, and they are also aware of the fact that it becomes very difficult for the NRIs to fight a legal battle. Usually, these kinds of properties which are owned by the NRIs are either joint or are given to the tenants, relatives, friends or some third party to take care of in their absence. As usual, what happens is greed plays its part and mischievous elements do not hesitate to seek illegal claim or have already claimed possession illegally over that particular property which was given to them for supervision by the NRIs in their absence in good faith. Now, as an obvious solution, what the NRIs can do is that they can approach the court of law and seek redressal. But on the other hand, the courts are already overburdened with such kinds of property disputes, and it becomes very difficult for the courts to provide relief to the NRIs as expeditious as it is required. Further, NRIs are forced to sell off their properties at throwaway prices, a strife to win at any cost in the property disputes by the rich in the real estate market as a matter of ego and dominance continues, which causes an immense harm and loss to the NRIs. Further, an amicable settlement or a prompt resolution by the way of arbitration disputes resolution system has worked very well to an extent in most of the cases. However, it is possible if and only if the matter is well represented by a legal expert who leads arbitration or out-of-court settlement in order to reach at a conclusion. Now, one of the most important factors which plays a vital role in dispute resolution is by the way of an expert legal agency, which provides them an appropriate legal advice and solutions in order to reach at a fruitful conclusion. Now, one of the major drawbacks of being an NRI is living far away from their homes. This is not only a drawback in an emotional sense, but also in a legal sense. Time and again, NRIs all across the globe have faced many kinds of disputes, such as illegal possession, tenant disputes, illegal sale of their hard-earned property and various other issues. Also, NRIs have faced many kinds of disputes which are related to the ownership, status or title of their property, verifying of all the documents, etc. So, this is the time where NRIs most often get confused or worried looking for an appropriate legal advice for free and hassle-free resolution to their problem. Now further, we will discuss what are the various causes of property disputes. Most of the disputes are pertaining to the title of the immovable property. Saying that a person has a good title over the immovable property refers to the fact that such a person has a right and interests over that particular property along with use, possession and income which is accrued by way of rent, etc. So you need to have a clear title which must be supported by the appropriate documentary evidence. Another kinds of disputes arise from the claims through co-owners or the joint owners, disputes because of easementary rights and various other issues which are involved. Another kinds of disputes arises when one party to the transaction after receiving the earnest money or the advance money refuses to perform his part of the contract, and what he does is approaches another buyer and takes consideration from him as well. So in these kinds of disputes, what the previous purchaser can do is that he can approach the court of law and contest for his title. There are also delay in delivery of possession by the builder to the buyer. and other kinds of disputes arise when one party inherits a property through a gift or under a will. Whenever a person acquires such a property, the another party may raise a contention that such a process of transferring the property through a gift or under a will is not valid under the eyes of law. With respect to the inherited property, disputes may arise when a purchaser buys a property without having any knowledge that it is already an inherited property. Another kinds of disputes are related to the real estate. Real estate disputes occurs due to fraudulent transactions. So these kinds of fraudulent transactions can be avoided if a person is a little cautious and well informed. Now further, I will elaborate these kinds of property disputes which are faced by NRIs and how NRIs can avoid such kinds of property disputes. First are the disputes pertaining to the ownership of the property. Saying that a person has a good title over the immovable property refers to the fact that such a person has a right to enjoy rights and interests over that particular property. So you need to have a clear title which must be supported by the appropriate documentary evidence. Since NRIs are living far away from their ancestral properties, it is always advised to execute a valid registered documents in order to protect one's property from any kind of interruptions from some third party. Also, NRIs must also have clarity as to the ownership status of their property, exact location, person in possession of that particular property, any latest development or regional plan, and current valuations, which the NRIs must know and which can be made known to them through a proper title search which is conducted by a reliable law firm. So you need to have a valid title as to the real estate property you own. If we talk about the title frauds are most common whenever you buy a standalone property. So in order to avoid these title frauds, a person must verify all the documents properly, and you can also use the services of a lawyer if required. Another kinds of disputes are related to the willed or inherited property. Disputes relating to the willed or inherited property are also quite common. Whenever a person acquires a property through a will, the another person may raise a contention that such a process of transferring the property or inheriting the property is not valid in the eyes of laws. Now, because of the absence of the digitized land records in our country, title frauds again become very common. Now further, disputes with the tenants pertaining to the property given on rent by NRIs. Most of the times, NRIs have left over their property under the tenant's care, and they do not return back for long durations to keep a check on it. As a result, what happens is the tenants take advantage of this situation. Now, they are not ready to pay the rent, or they are not ready to vacate that particular property even after the expiry of the rent agreement. So, it is always recommended that a duly registered rent agreement should be appropriately defined and signed by both the parties. Now, in case the tenant is not vacating the property, what the landlord can do is that he can send him a legal notice. If still the tenant is not vacating the property, then the landlord can approach the rent courts. Now, it is always recommended that the contract should be renewed by a rent agreement expert lawyer, and all the payments should be kept up to date. Preferably, all the payments which are made to the landlord should be made through checks or bank transactions. So these were the kinds of property disputes which were faced by NRIs, with all the possible solutions to it. So friends, if you found this video informative and productive, please like and share. In case of any query, you can drop a comment below or can write us on query@nrilegalservices.com. Thank you.